Clara, first of all, just tell us exactly what this is all about then. What's been decided in the last half hour?
Well, basically, those members of the European Parliament voted last night. The vote was revealed this morning. They have voted 400 votes for lifting the immunity of Carles Puigdemont and two other former members of his government. 248 of those MEPs voted against that lifting of the immunity. That essentially means that they considered that those members of the Catalan government only did not have immunity since this was an alleged crime that was committed before they won their seats in the Brussels Parliament. And as such, they can face justice. That opens the door, as you said, for the Spanish courts to reactivate that European arrest warrant. Those arrest warrants were paralysed in Belgium and in Scotland, where one of the other government members took refuge after she fled after that independence referendum. The Spanish jurists here are not expecting, however, that extradition to be speedy. The Catalan nationalists have already said that they will appeal this decision by the MEPs to the European Court of Justice. And we know, for instance, that in January, another former government member of the Catalan government in Belgium was to be extradited, but the Belgian court rejected that extradition. The Spanish judge says he will go to the European Court of Justice to ask them to make a ruling on whether Belgium is actually applying properly the terms of the European arrest warrant.
So remind us a bit more about what this is about, because it's almost 4 years ago now, isn't it? This was a major story, not only there in Spain and Catalonia, but right around the world, really.
That's right, Stuart. You'll remember that Carles Puigdemont headed up the Catalan regional government in the northeast of Spain, and him and the rest of his cabinet said that they would push ahead and hold an independence referendum on whether the region should break with the rest of Spain. They did that even though it was against the constitution, even though the courts banned that referendum. They pushed ahead, they held the votes, they counted them themselves, and on the basis of very low turnout, they declared the independence of the region. Now, Carles Puigdemont and a number of others fled abroad before they could face justice. But those that stayed behind, including the deputy president of Catalonia, Oriol Junqueras, faced trial and they were convicted. He was convicted, Junqueras, of 13 years in jail for sedition and abusing public money. The Spanish courts still want Carles Puigdemont and those other government members to face trial here in Spain.
Sarah, thanks very much. Sarah Morris, a correspondent, talking to us there from Madrid.